And welcome back. We had a lot of sunshine as we made our way through the day today. Temperatures once again about 15 degrees above average, as we did make 59 for a high in North Platte. So along with the sunshine, we did have that westerly wind that does keep us mild and dry. And we're going to keep our dry trend as we go through the next several days. So high temperatures today across the region, 55 at Ogallala and Imperial, upper 50s, McCook, Broken Bow, and Lexington. And we were into the mid-50s for highs from Thedford up toward Valentine. So temperatures have cooled off. We're at 27 at North Platte right now, 29 at Ogallala, near 30 at Hyannis and Thedford. Valentine still near 40, but the cool spot is Lexington right now, 25 degrees. There's your westerly wind continuing to keep us dry. It was windy today, and the dry air did cool off pretty quickly, and the winds have died down. Right now, wind speeds between 5 and 15 miles per hour. So the Doppler radar shows that the clear skies are working their way off to the east, and we have more bands of clouds working their way in. They should warm us up nicely as we make our way through the overnight, still staying mainly dry across the region. All the moisture missing us off to the north into the Dakotas, this low pressure system, and another one off to the east. That's where all the moisture is across the country, and the cool air too. High pressure is really in charge of our forecast. Our next weather maker is going to come down from Canada, and that's going to happen as we go through the day tomorrow. It will increase the clouds. We're still in a nice warm sector here. Still a little windy, breezy to windy, we'll say, as we go through the next few days. This high pressure system will keep us on the dry side. Let's take a look at what to expect on the skycast. Lots of cloud cover during the overnight period. So low temperatures are going to be very mild into the upper 20s. We might not even lose a lot more temperature compared to where we are right now to start off tomorrow morning. Now, high temperatures as we go through the day tomorrow with a lot of sunshine in the morning will be into the lower 50s. More cloud cover moving through into the evening. Now, for your Wednesday evening, there's a very slight chance of some rain or even some snow showers into the sand hills. It looks like it should be light, and most of us aren't going to get anything. Temperatures falling back through the mid-30s into the upper 20s again to start off your Thursday, which should be dry, windy too. But temperatures will reach the upper 50s once again as we stay very mild. So the high pressure system over us right now works its way off to the south. This low pressure system is riding the jet stream south. So we do have that cold front that could give us a very slight chance of some rain or snow showers for your Wednesday evening tomorrow. But we will continue to keep that strong westerly flow. Temperatures cooling a little into the weekend, but that westerly flow really keeping us on the dry side. So low temperatures tonight, mid-20s to near 30, depending on where you are. We will cool down for the day tomorrow with more cloud cover. So only in the lower 50s, we make our way back into the upper 50s to near 60 with mostly sunny to partly cloudy skies as we go through the day on Thursday. Let's take a look at the extended forecast. Breezy to windy as we go through the next few days. Temperatures at 53 for Wednesday, 57 for the day on Thursday, and 48 for Friday, starting off the weekend into the lower 40s. Lots of sunshine, highs in the upper 50s to near 60. Still staying dry and mostly cloudy and a little cooler, 54 for Tuesday. Kent?
And talk about that wind, a little more windy today, and then we could also see that pick up here in a couple days as well.
Yeah, we'll keep the wind. Most of us will stay dry, though.
All right. Thanks so much, Justin. A staggering number of people who recently used alcohol and marijuana say they drove under the influence. According to a study by the American Journal of